Something sure smells. Must be sulfur in that water.
How great is it that the golden age of Hollywood is preserved in these old films? Hi, I'm J.D. Whitney, and welcome to my snippets of remembering old Hollywood. Thanks to the film festivals of the 80s and 90s, we have access to clips of industry professionals remembering that golden age. Here is actor, singer, Rex Allen Sr., along with director, William Witney, remembering their friend, actor, stuntman, rodeo clown, and bullfighter, Slim Pickens.
Yeah, I rodeoed some with Slim. Played rodeo, did my act in the arena when Slim was bullfighting. And knew Slim quite a while long before. I had no idea that Slim would ever work with me in pictures. I don't think he had any picture ambitions at that time, but Bill Whitney and Joe Irgoyne found him more or less.
You found him. You brought him in to meet me.
Yeah.
You're the one responsible.
Well, I loved him, and I'll never forget, if I live a thousand years. I forget the name of the picture, but Slim and I were going down the coast trying to beat some sailing ships to San Diego from San Francisco, and we're racing horseback by shore, and the boat's this way. There's some bad guys on that boat. And I had a line to Slim that said something to the effect, well, we're going to have to make it to San Diego in the next 8 hours, or they're going to beat us and be gone. And Slim's line was, they ain't stopped us yet. Well, what he said was, they ain't stopped us yet. That Slim. You know what you're saying? He says, yeah, they ain't stopped us yet. They ain't stopped us yet. Well, it took about two takes like that. He still said, they ain't stopped us yet. Print it. Well, that's still in the film.
I think the funniest thing, the first picture, Rex is in a fight. And I said, look, I want you to root for Rex. You know, come on, Rex, hit him, do something. So we roll the camera, and he looks at me, and I said, go on, Slim, holler like you mean it, holler right at me. I'm standing off the side of the camera, and he says, stomp a mud hole in him, Rex, and then stomp it dry. I said, what did you say? Slim told me once, after about the middle of the picture, I said, Slim, how do you like being in pictures? He says, you know, now remember, he was a bullfighter. He says, you know, that camera ain't run over me once. And then one day he said, you know, we were talking about bullfighting, and he had a little guy that was always put in the barrel, Buddy Heaton. And he said, we're talking about bullfighting, and Slim says, you know, the only trouble with bullfighting, Buddy, is the bulls don't drink. Yes, I remember Slim Pickens, God love him. He was a hell of a talent. I gave him his first dramatic role in a picture that had John Derrick in it, The Outcast. And there was a scene in there of Slim where he hasn't got anything to do. And he said, Billy, I'm just sitting here. I said, look, you're going to ride down the hill in a minute. Start pulling bullets out. Fill the gun up and try to get the wind. When you start to stuff your face with bullets like this. So he did, and it was in the picture. So one day he stopped by the house. He lived quite a bit further out in Tarzana than I did. My house was known as a pit stop. So Slim comes in, and I said, where are you going, Slim? He said, I got a interview with Marlon Brando on a picture they're going to make. So So I came back and I said, stopped again and had a drink. And I said, how'd the interview go, Slim? He said, well, you know, he said, McBrando said to me, you know, Slim, I like thinking actors. Now that scene you did in that Ouscast picture where you put the bullets in your mouth, he said, now that's a thinking actor. I said, did you tell him where it came from? He said, hell no.
One year to work, and Slim was going to fight bulls up there, and we had done a couple pictures together. At the border, they're very, very finicky about what you bring into Canada, and they're especially looking for guns and all that type of thing. Slim had three big old duffel bags, and they're open, had opened up two of them and gone through everything, and this guy, customs man, looks at the lab, he says, what do you got in that one? Slim says, underwear. What in God's world do you need with all that underwear? He says, if you're fighting bulls, you'd need it too.
Mr. Allen and Mr. Pickens went to work for someone at Disney's who had a bunch of trained dogs. So these are sheepdogs, and so they were supposed to chase Slim up a tree. Well, one of the dogs was faster than Slim and just bit a hole in him like you couldn't believe. And they've got to take him to the doctor. So they rush Slim to the doctor, and now the frontier doctor sitting here, it goes along. So they pull Slim into the and put him on the table and look at his leg, and the doctor takes his scalpel out and goes like this, and the frontier doctor face.
And that is true. Yes, the Sam Peckinpah, that you brought it up, that I think I'd like to share with you. Sam had a kind of reputation of being a hard director to work for. And he liked that battery acid pretty good too. And he just didn't have the reputation of a Bill Witney, for instance. And they were doing this picture somewhere down in Mexico, and Sam said to Slim, he says, Slim, come over to my room and have a drink with me after we break. I want to talk to you. So Slim went over and had a drink with him. He said, Slim, you know, all these kind of parts that I've got in these pictures, I can't. Ben Johnson wants all the damn money in the world, and so-and-so wants all the money in the world. I want you to know, I'm going to give you all them parts from now on. Sam said, well, thank you, Sam. By God, maybe you'll make a big star out of me, and I won't have to work for you either.
Well,
I'm
working the rodeo at Cheyenne or one of those places. And he loved to hunt and fish, so he meets this Indian who says, come on, Slim, I'll take you hunting and fishing. So they, for 2 days, they took their sleeping bags and was apparently great on the reservation, good fishing and hunting and whatever they were doing. And Slim bypassed, he said, if you ever get downtown, come to see us. So this about 4 weeks later, I go over to see Slim one morning. He lived not too far from me. And there's three teepees on his front door. So I look at this and I go in. Maggie opens the door. She's got a face about his wife about this long, and I said, what are the teepees, Maggie? And she says, I've been cooking corn and hunting buffalo. He said, that's your friend Slim. I said, where is he? She says, I don't know. He's afraid to show his face.
I got a story for you on Slim. He
won.
He still rodeoed a lot after he was making pictures with me at Republic, because they were not notorious, let's say, for paying very big salaries at Republic. And Slim was still clowning, fighting bulls, you know, and he was on his way to Calgary, and he had a little old horse trailer. I swear, the wheelbase wasn't over about that wide. It was a single horse trailer that he hauled old John in, this horse, this Appaloosa horse, and here's some pictures. He called me one morning from Great Falls, Montana. He said, "Can you wire me $300? And I said, "What's the matter?" He said, "Well, I turned old John over out on the highway and drug him and stuff, and he says, I've got to get my trailer fixed so I can get on to Calgary at the rodeo." And I said, "How's John?" He said, "Well, he took me a half a day to find him." "Where was he?" He said, "He was down at City Hall trying to get my driver's license to vote."
About Slim Pickens here for at least an hour with funny stories about him. I went to see him in Las Vegas at a rodeo. He was a rodeo clown. He fought the bulls. This old bull hit him and knocked him down, and Slim somehow got up and draped the cape over him, and he ran for the. There was a bunch of equipment stacked there, and Slim just made it before the bull, his old bull rooting after him, and Slim comes up and sits on the fence. He's this close to me, and he says, "Billy, I'm going to look back, but if that bull climbs this fence and sits up alongside of me, I'm giving up rodeo." We had him in a barrel on one of Rex's pictures. Now, this old bull didn't seem to like Pickens, and he's trying to dig him out of this barrel. And Slim is back in the barrel as far as he can go, and he said, "Somebody get me out of here, distracting." So I'm not about to go in there. I look at Rex and he says, "Forget it." So we look at Irgoyen, and Joe says, "Okay, Slim, well, what do I do?" He says, "Jump over the fence and just wave the deal." Joe says, "I'll wave it from this side of the fence." Says, "Won't do any good." He says, "He wants you, not the cape." So finally Joe says, "Oh God, what'd he say?" He says, "Okay, we gotta get him out of there somewhere." So he jumps over the fence, this old bull charges, and Slim came out of there he was a hell of an athlete. And he charges out of there, and he says, "Oh boy, those horses were that close to me." But when we had a bunch of guys coming out, making a mount, and taking off, I always shot it in three cuts. You run them out to the horses, because you run five or six guys out to a horse, you can't ever get them on. Then I'd cut to something, a horse rearing or something, and then I would say, "Okay, let's go, action," and everybody would swing into the saddle at the same time, and they'd ride out. Well, I always went on that shot, I'd always hold Slim back off stage. And I'd say, "I'll tell you when to go, Slim." And old John was usually a wrangler holding him till the last with a wire or something, so he wouldn't run off the horses. And everybody would get on, and I'd say, "Go, Slim." Well, by now they've taken off. And here comes Slim. And if he could get a hold of any part of that horse, you see it in these, he's got a tail, any part of that horse, he was on it and gone. Now there's a few times that he wound up on the ground, and he didn't think too much of that, did he?
Alan's movies, they didn't hear any singing. Was there any particular reason for that?
Was what?
In several of Rex Allen's movies, he did not hear any singing. Was there any particular reason for that?
Well, he sang on all the pictures I made, I'm sure, but not only that, just to sharpen him up, I let Slim Pickens sing with him. And that made him a little better singer. He tried a little harder for me.
Know how he tried.
He started to bucking and jumping around. It's now been 8 years and I still can't sit down.
Slim, the shells?
Sure, that's the best part.
Many memories of an old friend. Well, see you next time.